We knew Venn diagrams or set diagrams since middle school. They help us see how sets intersect with each other. But have you ever tried to draw the Venn diagram for four sets? We all know how to draw for two and three sets, but personally, I haven't tried going for four sets. But what's the big deal? You can see people drawing four-set Venn diagrams on the internet, like this one. Well, let's try drawing it on our own. As usual, we start with a Venn diagram on two sets, say A and B. When we add another set C, it should intersect both previously drawn circles, right? Because otherwise, there is no region that lies inside all of A, B, and C. Now, let's add our fourth set, say D. As before, it should intersect all three of the previously drawn circles. And boom, we get a Venn diagram for four sets. Right? Just wait a minute. Look at the regions that are inside A and C. These regions are completely covered by B and D, so that means there is no region in this figure which is inside A and C, but outside B and D. But these regions should exist, right? Let's just say A stands for people who like apples, B for those who like bananas, C for those who like coconuts, and D for those who like durian. So according to our figure, there will be no one in this world who likes apples and coconuts, but hates bananas and durian. This of course is not the case, so we must have drawn the diagram in the wrong way. So, how do we draw? To answer that, let's go back to three circles. Here, these three circles divide the plane into eight regions. Each of these regions carries the information of whether they are inside or outside of a particular set. For example, this region right here lies inside of A, but outside of B and C. And this region right here lies inside of B and C, but outside of A. And so on and so forth. When we add our new set D, we want each of these regions to be split into two pieces, one part lying inside of D, and one part lying outside of D. So, when we add our set D, what we need is to intersect every region exactly once, not just circles. That being said, we're at our fourth circle, and let's try moving it around to see if we can cut every region into two parts. Will this work? No, because this region right here was not cut into two pieces, and hence, there will be no region that lies inside of A, outside of B, outside of C, and inside of D. Okay, what about now? Will this work? No, because this region right here is completely covered. We want to cut through the region, not a cover. Also, notice in this picture, the outside region also was not cut into two pieces. After trying this for a while, you might sense that this task is impossible. And you'll be right. It is actually impossible to draw a four-set Venn diagram out of circles. Notice the wording here. It is impossible to draw with circles. If we think outside of the box, in this case outside of the circles, we can easily solve this problem. Look, here is one curve that cuts through each of the eight regions exactly once. In fact, there's more than just one. Here is another that does the job. If you want a more pleasing figure, you can start out with or ellipses instead of circles. Here, we draw the first two ellipses just like in the case with circles. Here is the third ellipse, still forming a Venn diagram. And the fourth, and it cuts through all the eight regions created by the previous three ellipses. There, we get our precious, beautiful Venn diagram for four sets. In fact, with ellipses, you can even draw a Venn diagram for five sets. Like this. This drawing, however, is completely different from what we have seen before. digits not produced by adding more and more ellipses to the previous diagrams. In fact, if you remove any one of the ellipses, the resulting diagram is no longer a Venn diagram. Okay, let's stop praising ellipses and ask exactly why the circles are bad. The main difference between circles and ellipses is that the circle is more symmetric than the ellipse. You see, two circles can intersect in at most 2 points, while two ellipses can intersect in at most 4 points. So with ellipses, we can create more regions than with circles. The main reason why circles fail is that they do not produce enough regions when we have 4 sets. The proof is quite simple. We just need to ask 2 questions. Question 1. How many regions do we need for an n set Venn diagram? And question 2. How many regions can we create with n circles? To answer the first question, let's look back at a Venn diagram with 3 sets. Well, we need one region inside all of A, B, and C. We need one that is inside A, inside B, but outside C, and so on. If you list out all the possible combinations and count up, you'll see that you need exactly 8 regions to draw a 3-set Venn diagram. You can also count this without listing the possibilities. Look at this. For set A, we want regions to be either inside of A or outside of A. So that's 2 choices. The same goes for B and C, with 2 choices for B and 2 choices for C. Since we're making these choices independently, the total number of regions we need is 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. By the exact same argument, in general, for n set Venn diagram, you will need exactly 2 to the power of n regions. Now, let's take a look at the second question. How many regions can we create with n circles? With 1 circle, well, you can create 2 regions. With 2 circles, you can create 4. And with 3 circles, you can create 8. Well, the number of regions is 2, 4, 8. And what's the next number? Let's check. If we count the number of regions in this figure, we'll see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, and up to 14 regions. The pattern is broken, and that is actually the reason why the 4-set Venn diagrams are impossible to draw with circles. Now, let's see exactly why the pattern breaks, and we get 14 regions instead of 16. First, take a picture with 4 circles, and then replace the 4th circle with a shadow trail and mark the intersections it makes with the previous 3 circles. After that, we trace the 4th circle by following the shadow starting from one of the intersections. Notice that whenever our pen hits an intersection, it might create a new region because the arc we just drawn cuts through some region into 2 parts. And that is the only way the regions can be created. So, the number of new regions cannot exceed the number of new intersections. Since each pair of circles intersect in at most 2 points and there are 3 previously drawn circles, the number of new intersections is at most this. So, total number of regions is at most 8 plus this, which is 14. This means that with 4 circles, we can never create more than 14 regions. Obviously, the method we use to count the regions created by circles can be continued for n circles in general. For example, for the 5th circle, there will be 4 previously drawn circles. Hence, there will be at most 8 new intersections. So the number of regions is at most 22. Continuing, we get 32 regions with 6 circles, 44 regions with 7 circles, and so on. In general, with n circles, there will be at most n squared minus n plus 2 regions. Take a moment to think about how we get this formula. By the way, if you know Euler's polyhedron formula, this one, there is an ordinate and more rigorous method to get this formula. Anyway, if we compare what we can create versus what we need, it is easy to see that the difference gets worse and worse. An easy way to argue why this difference gets worse and worse is that what we can create is a quadratic polynomial, while what we need is an exponential function. Since exponential grows really, really fast compared to the quadratic, indeed, the difference will get worse and worse. So with circles, we cannot do four sets. What about ellipses? We have seen that they can hold up to 5 sets, but unfortunately, they can't do 6 sets. This follows by the exact same argument we did with circles. So what about a more asymmetric shape, let's say rectangles? Well, 2 rectangles can intersect in at most 8 points, so we can generate even more regions. Will this be enough? The answer, no. In fact, any reasonable curve you can think of will be bad. 2 to the power of n is just too much. Suppose you have a bag of curves which you can draw a Venn diagram of any number of sets. But let's say any 2 curves from your bag intersect in not more than k points for some constant k. So for a bag of circles, k would be 2, and for a bag of ellipses, k would be 4. As before, we can compute the number of regions we can get using the same technique. Just watch. As our k is a constant, the formula is still a quadratic polynomial. As n gets bigger and bigger, this number will eventually be smaller than 2 to the power of n. This means that, in order to be able to draw Venn diagrams of any number of sets, your bag needs to contain curves that can create arbitrarily large number of intersections. So you cannot just stick to one curve and expect it to draw all the Venn diagrams you need. All of these are just considering about producing enough regions. We haven't even talked about making the right intersections at all. No matter how crazy it sounds, mathematicians still manage to come up with crazier bags that can create Venn diagrams of any size. For example, mathematician Branko Granbaum proved that your bag only needs to consist of convex polygons. Quite surprising after seeing the last argument, right? But I won't be showing his construction today. Instead, what we are going to see in this video is this. This construction we will show is due to mathematician and logician John Venn, who made Venn diagrams popular in the first place. If you look closely, you can see the 4-set Venn diagram that we used to cheat at the beginning of this video. Venn's construction is basically the continued version of this. So, we will go back to our 3-set diagram and add more curves as we go on. Adding the 4th curve is easy. We can find a curve that passes through all 8 regions just by using our eyes. Now, adding the 5th curve gets a little bit trickier. As before, we want our 5th curve to pass through all the 16 regions created by previous 4 curves. Now, imagine yourself walking around the 4th curve anticlockwise, starting from one of the intersections. If you look on your left and right as you walk, you will be able to see all 16 regions of this 4-set Venn diagram. Specifically, 8 regions on your left and 8 on your right. This is because of the way we drew the fourth curve, and take a moment to make it clear. If we enlarge our fourth curve just a little bit, we get a curve that cuts through all 8 regions on your right. Likewise, if we shrink our curve just a little bit, we get a curve that cuts through all 8 regions on your left. Then, all we need to do is combine these two curves at the starting point, like this. You can easily check that this new curve cuts through all the 16 regions into 2 pieces. Obviously, this construction can be continued to any number of sets. Enlarge the curve a little, shrink it a bit, and join at the intersection. If you look at the figure John Venn has given, squint your eyes a little bit, and you'll see that this is exactly how we drew these. After Venn has popularized the Venn diagrams, many other mathematicians also came up with their own constructions. The construction I would really love to show in this video is this, which is known as the GKS construction. Anyway, this video has been going for a while, so let's stop it here. If you liked the video, make sure to give it a like, and subscribe if you wish, and see you next time.